During Lent, let us find concrete ways to overcome our indifference. Pope Francis. A blessed Thursday to all of you joining us in prayer. Around the world, we have brothers and sisters right now who are with you in prayer. How beautiful is that? It's the third week of Lent, and we've been gifted another day to love and to be loved and to thank God for it all. I'm Father Ron. Thanks for joining us. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
A reading from the Book of Psalms, Psalm 95, verses 7 to 9. Oh, that today you would hear his voice. Harden not your hearts as at Meribah, as in the day of Massa in the desert, where your fathers tempted me. They tested me, though they had seen my works. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today's scripture references a contentious time in the history of God's people. In the book of Exodus, we read that as the people of Israel moved through the desert towards the Promised Land, they found a place to camp. However, there was no water for them to drink. Scripture tells us, "Therefore the people quarreled with Moses and grumbled against him, saying, 'Why did you bring us up out of Egypt to kill us and our children and our livestock with thirst?'" Moses cried out to God for help, and God commanded him to strike the rock at Horeb with his staff. Through a miracle, God caused water to come forth from the rock. Moses then called the name of the place Massa, which means testing, and Meribah, which means quarreling, because of, as Scripture says, the quarreling of the people of Israel, and because they tested the Lord by saying, "Is the Lord among us or not?" Here we see the people of Israel quick to abandon and forget all that God had done for them. He had rescued them from slavery. He defeated their enemies in the Red Sea, and he even provided miraculous bread from heaven for them to eat. But they forgot these blessings. They forgot God's promise to be with them and to care for them. How often do we do the same? How often do we harden our hearts to God's faithfulness and turn away from him when things become difficult? This invites us to reflect on a number of really important virtues: the virtues of justice, gratitude, and religion. The virtue of gratitude is the virtue by which we offer our thanks to a benefactor. The virtue of gratitude is part of the cardinal virtue of justice. Through justice, we give God and others what they are due. Therefore, by showing gratitude to our benefactors, whether it be God, our parents, or anyone else, we are living with the cardinal virtue of justice. Now, St. Thomas Aquinas reminds us that God is the primary cause of all blessings. He is the source of all goodness. Therefore, the gratitude we owe God is greater than the thanks we must give to our parents or to any other benefactor. And the only just way to show God our gratitude is through another virtue, the virtue of religion. In other words, the only just response to God as our benefactor is to give him our worship in prayer. This is the heart of our reflection today. When God blesses us, do we offer him our gratitude in worship and prayer? I know that I, like the Israelites, often grumble and murmur against God instead of remaining close to him in prayer. I can pray very easily when things go well, but when I encounter difficulties, I turn to cursing and to sin instead of leaning closer into God through prayer and worship. When we regularly practice prayer, we choose to spend time in God's presence and to give our whole selves to him in worship. This is true gratitude to God. God wants us to be close to him, not just in the good times, but also in hardship. So when we find ourselves in the deserts of the spiritual life, may we never forget God and his blessings, but instead live with gratitude and justice by remaining close to him in prayer. Let the name of Jesus be praised, both now and forever. Amen.
Our special intercession today is for those who suffer, whose dreams lie in the tomb, that the divine promise to open all graves and raise the dead may be active, bringing them healing and hope. And with our own prayers in our hearts, we now pray together.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, how I want the peace in my heart that comes from spiritual humility. I want the humility that rests in your wise dealings, the humility that makes bitterness impossible. You are gentle and humble in heart. Teach my heart this truth. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And together we pray our Lenten Marian prayer.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Beneath your compassion, hear our petitions and rescue us from all temptation, O glorious and blessed Virgin Mary. Amen.
Before we end, those new to our prayer family here at the God Minute, don't forget that every weekday in Lent, Father Michael and myself take turns putting out a short, like 90-second video of reflection called The Word. Just take random words and we lift them into spiritual significance. supposed to be kind of whimsical and spiritual. I hope you might enjoy it. You'll see the menu for it on our app. It's right next to the daily prayer menu. Just tap there and you can see them all lined up. Check them out, I hope. And folks, may God now bless you in peace and protection in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We'll see you tomorrow.